Justin Tucker set to boom this one away. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. First down, Watson. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. The drive starting play, a good one, given 19. And we see the emphasis early here. Get your star receiver involved, able to do it successfully.
Not a bad start to begin with, that's for sure. And to me, this play says, our guy is better than your guy's. Because, you know, a player of his stature, he won't just be single covered all game long. It's going to involve multiple people. And right away, they told the other team, guess what? He's just better.
Now a first down throw, Watson. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
Here's Watson. Trying to get it to Thomas, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, C.J. Mosley. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. Jackson and the Ravens come up now, first and 10 at their own 24.
Detroit!
Here's the first carry for Alex Collins. And he'll take it forward for about 5 up to the 28-yard line.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Second down, Jackson. He gets this one to Michael Crabtree. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
Detroit! Detroit! Watch it now, Barney! Barney! Mike 41!
Here's a first down run with Collins. And he goes across midfield and down into Houston territory. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On second down, here's Jackson. Looking sideline, incomplete. He was trying to get it to Michael Crabtree there, and it's third down.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely, just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. On third down, Jackson. He finds Crabtree for the completion. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Usually hitting a deep post pattern, as we just saw there, for a big gainer, that's tough to do because you usually have a safety or two in the middle of the field. But if you hit enough crossers and underneath routes and curls, you start to get those guys creeping up, wanting to make plays on the football. It's the equivalent of a changeup in baseball. You show your other stuff, throw the changeup, and on that play, it worked for big yardage.
First red zone chance now for the Ravens. They've got a first and goal just inside the five.
Lucky 56. Lucky 56.
This is Collins on the handoff. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. Line of scrimmage, again the four-yard line. Second and goal. Going to set him back 5 yards. Can't afford another delay here as they come up again on second and goal.
Back in the net, Philly. Here we go.
Jackson. Got a man. It's caught for a Ravens touchdown. Michael Crabtree. Yard touchdown grab, and the Ravens have taken the early lead. Personally, for him, a great opening drive. He had 3 catches, including the touchdown.
That felt like tremendous scouting, great film watching, and creating a game plan to start this off, not only to get him involved, but to send a message to the defense. You have a lot to handle in this one.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Texans offense now, they get set to head back on the field here. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know what, a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, and it's Texans football as we get going in quarter number 2. And they've got it here with a first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Richmond, Richmond.
Watson on first down. Try to force it to Hopkins, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Eric Weddle. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. Interception. Here's Jackson toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete. That one was intended for John Brown, and now it's second down.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he let him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
From midfield now, here's Jackson. Under pressure here, and down he goes. Sacked back at about the 43-yard line.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
Crabtree with it over the middle. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. The 21 yards there as they convert on third.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
A give left side to Collins, and he won't get much. Maybe a couple down inside the 35 to the 34.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Now Jackson on second down. Wide open receiver complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. That'll put him over 100 yards receiving now here in this first half of action.
56. Lucky 56.
On the give. This is Collins running left. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain, considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Now let's go. Blue 90. Blue 90.
To throw is Jackson. Looking to throw on second down. It's caught by Crabtree. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.
Detroit!
Jackson looking to throw on third. Forced out to his left. Crabtree has it, and he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. On first and goal, Collins. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. It's second and goal, back to the 8-yard line now. They get it to him running left. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal. This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? And this is caught. Touchdown, Baltimore. As his guys are in for 6, and the Ravens will add on to their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. Running right through it. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Heading out is the Texans' offense as they get set to take over here. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that 0 off the board. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They go play action here on first down. He sets to fire deep. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey. And an alley to run. And they will finally stop him as he's down to the 40-yard line.
You hear me laughing, partner, and I'm not laughing at the situation, but sometimes you just get yourself into a rut. It's hard to shake yourself out of it.
First down with Jackson. Man up on the left side is Brown. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. As the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. This quarterback now 9 of 11 passing in this first half. He's got his guys at first and 10.
Gun, gun! Gun, gun! All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Here's Jackson. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
After the incomplete pass, right, here now is second and 10.
Alert, alert. Three out. All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Now Jackson throwing again. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone. So now third and 10, a big play to start the drive, but nothing since. Jackson throwing once more and almost picked off. I guess the good news for them now, it's fourth down. So they won't get a touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get three to end the first half. A 33-yarder from the left hash. And Tucker's kick right there. It's good. And the lead will grow. It's now 17-0. So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get three.
And I've talked with enough players nowadays that when they have these types of kicks, that no one says to their guy, hey, that's just like making an extra point, piece of cake. Because the extra point's not a piece of cake anymore. But kicking a field goal from that distance, just give him confidence and let him knock it through.
So we're at halftime here in the Inner Harbor with the hometown Ravens on top. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? The return man, Chris Moore. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Out come the Ravens now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team. That their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
It's still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A really good pickup of 28 yards. First and 10, it's Jackson. He's going deep for Brown. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Justin Reed. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. They needed a break. They needed to make a play here in the third quarter. Defensively, they did that. Now they got to go quickly and get some points on the board.
And the best part is that they made their own break, taking the ball away. Now they just look at their offense and saying, guys,
let's go.
Come on, capitalize on this one.
They'll try and get the run game going. This is Miller. Only able to get it to his own 20 after breaking through the contact. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. Underneath for Miller. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. It goes as a gain of eight, and it moves the chains. On first down, it's Watson, flush to his right. Hopkins on the grab over the middle. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A good pickup there of 20 yards.
think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Brandon Carr. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. He couldn't get the hook up there that time with Thomas. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 44.
Lucky 56. Lucky 56.
They'll begin the drive with Collins. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. It's Kareem Jackson making the play defensively. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
To throw on second down, Jackson. Caught left side to Crabtree. And oh, he coughed it up! And the Texans say they have it, they do!
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
Good starting field position for the Houston Texans here as they come up first and 10. Following the fumble recovery, Watson. Throw left side complete to QT. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
A good pickup there, a 22. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Well, they certainly have been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that?
And now here's another interception. Picked off by Tavon Young. Thought they had something going there to break that goose egg here in the second half, but to no avail.
Hope was alive until that interception. What a terrific play, taking the ball away after it looked like they were starting a drive.
And now that shutout still standing. You know that's something those defensive guys hold a lot of pride on, too.
No doubt about it. They are excited about where they are in this game.
This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, I know.
Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Whitney Merciless leading the surge there. He drops him for a loss of 6.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast, and a big sack. Now it's Jackson. Over the middle here to Brown. He's at the 50, the 30, the 20.